Welcome to another episode of Pokemon Ultra Sun! Today we're headed to the Pokemon Center. It's the first one we're encountering in this game. Here, let me show you the Pokemon Center. Follow me! Wow! I've never been in one of these before! What a crazy experience! If you talk to the woman at the counter, she can restore your Pokemon to perfect health. It's amazing, isn't it? I can't stand seeing Pokemon in pain. You can also deposit Pokemon on the PC here and take them out. And at the Pokemart, you can buy all kinds of items that should help you during your trials. I'd take a look if I were you. Over there is the cafe area. I like to relax there sometimes with a frosty glass of Moomoo milk. I read something in a travel guide about Alola once. Apparently each Pokemon Center in Alola offers a different selection of drinks. Is there green tea here? I wonder how many they serve. The cafes may also offer more than just drinks. I heard they also have special treats and that sometimes the staff have tips for trial goers. Well, that's actually really helpful. We should head to the trainer school next, but have your Pokemon taken care of first if you think they need a little aid. I'm pretty sure mine don't because I just went to my mom before starting the episode, but let's check out what these people gotta see. You use communication features to train Pokemon with a friend, you'll both be happy. It basically doubles your... Wait, are you sure? What if they send me a really bad Pokemon? Okay, welcome to the Pokemon Center Cafe. It's about 9 now in Alola. Here in our cafe space, we provide a moment of peace to our customers. Well, you've given your Pokemon 19 Pokebeans. I have been feeding mine. Pokebeans make Pokemon happy. I think I'll give you a present. Oh yes, you got a rare candy. I'm gonna save that for later. Try giving your Pokemon some Pokebeans when your island challenge gets rough. Excuse me, sir. Where is the tea on the menu? I am lacking a tea option. I'm gonna buy Moomoo milk. Oh, it costs... Oh, actually, we have lots of money. I want to save it for once we get to the first clothing store in the game, though, so we can change up our outfit and our look, because we're gonna get a super cute outfit. Just one sip and you'll be hooked. This milk is so mellow yet rich. I thought it said yellow for a second. I was kind of like, ew? That it'll make you wish your mother were a milk tank. Vehicle sharing convenient. You can get to where you're going a whole lot faster than if you had to just walk everywhere. So by convenient, I mean they'll save you a lot of time. You're limited to one per day, but have a tea biscuit on us. But there's no tea! This snack is a specialty of Shellor City in the Kalos region. Oh, Shellor Sable. Oh, that's really cool. So we got something from Kalos. We'd like to offer your Pokemon something on the house. Yes, you got more Pokebeans. I was worried I'd run out. Pokebeans are a specialty in Alola and Pokemon love to eat them. Feed them to your Pokemon. Pokemon refresh and they'll become more affectionate. Alright, thank you. Hi there. Any Pokemon trainer in the world can have their Pokemon healed or use a PC here for free. I thought those were Pokeballs in the pond thing here, and I thought he was playing like one of those like carnival games where you like use the fishing hook to pick up a Pokeball, but no! It's just flowers, but they're cute. Okay, so you're saying you can't have more than 6 Pokemon. Good stuff. You buy and sell things at the Pokemart. Thanks, kid. I appreciate your efforts to help me. Okay, let's buy some stuff. We're probably gonna need it. I have 10 Pokeballs. You know what? Just in case there's an emergency, I'm gonna buy 10 more. Just in case there's an emergency, you never know. In case I see something like a bunny ear again, I need lots of Pokeballs. I want to be prepared. Potions. I'll buy some antidotes. 5 of these. Normally I buy 5 of like all of these when I go shopping. Because I feel like 5 is a good number. Because you might need it, you might not need it. So might as well get 5. And even if you don't need it now, you might need it later. So usually I like to buy 5 of everything. Except for the escape rope and repels. Usually I don't buy those. I like to fight everything that comes my way. Everything that's thrown at me, I like to fight it. It's never ready to go. I'm pretty sure I already healed earlier, so we should be fine. I don't think we need to heal. But now is our chance to go to the Pokemon Trainer School. Here we are. You see what Trainer School is? It's a... what in the world? It's a Tauros! Hi, buddy. Are you one of Ash's? Did you get away? Well, it looks like we won't be going that way anytime soon thanks to Tauros there. But we were only planning to go as far as the Trainer School anyway. We'll just leave that for someone else to deal with. Come follow me. Well, maybe that's... mind, but I have more in mind. What do you think we'll find at this trainer school place? I don't know, Rotom. I guess we'll find out. I'm gonna try to read Rotom's text once in a while. Hey there, Sappy. I must have passed you two somehow, yeah? Well, welcome to the trainer school, the place to learn how to be a Pokemon trainer. I see a nice shiny Pokeball right there. Professor Cookie, is this the child you told me about? Your Sappy's a real tough one, too. Put her through the ringer, good teach. Four trainers! You gotta be four trainers here at the school, Sappy. The experience will surely help you and your Pokemon grow stronger. Actually, speaking of experience, why don't you take this? Oh yeah, we got the experience here. That could be helpful. If you keep that experience here, Anya, all the Pokemon on your team can get experience points from battle. The trainers who will take part in this lesson may be inside or outside the school. You may also want to visit our classrooms. You'll learn things there that will help you on your journey, I'd say. Alright, let the lesson begin. Are there items in the rooms? She may not look all that tough, but that teach trains her kids right. One of our students is even a captain. If you want a bit of advice from me, here's something that might help. Once you've fought a species of Pokemon once, you can see what types of moves it will be weak to in your next battle. Wandering about in the tall grass to me, lots of different Pokemon will help with that. Battle all the time, yeah? That's actually one feature I really, really like that they added to the game, is the fact that you can see weaknesses after you fought a Pokemon once, which I think is really nice because I'm not very good at remembering type advantages. My precious Bonsly once takes damage in a Pokemon battle, I'll want to use a potion on it. I have to talk to these guys, they don't have the thing like I have you in my sights now, so let's battle. You were challenged by youth athlete Hiromi, she's so cute. I know that she's holding like a tennis racket thing, but it looks like a fan, and I have a fan obsession. I've got another fan actually, guys. Some of you might remember I have an obsession with fans, or if you're new, you might not know I have an obsession with fans. And I got a new one, and here, listen to it. I'm gonna just fan your guys' faces for a while through the microphone. I don't know if that's working, it's probably not working, but it's really pretty. I got a pink fan, and now I got a white fan. And they're super cute, and they both have like flower patterns. And I have a fan obsession! Oh yeah, I have a Soggy out front. They're both level 11 now because I trained them a little bit. I wanted to make sure they were ready to go because I only have two Pokemon on my team anyway. So I wanted to make sure they were good to go for the next couple fights. I should probably switch your Soggy out because the Soggy's not doing too well here. Oh, Popo's actually level 12. I take it back. He's a higher level. Maybe I should turn on the experience here soon. Maybe I should use a Bonsly on my team. Do I want to do that? I don't know. I guess we'll see what we find in the grass. I think I'm just gonna take whatever pops up. If I really, really like a Pokemon that pops up, I'll take it. If there's nothing that catches my eyes, I won't take any. Yeah, I think we'll go with that system. It's super effective! And also, I'll try not to repeat types too much, because don't want to repeat too many, right? Don't worry, I'll heal any pain that was caused by our defeat. Yay, that's the first trainer down. We got three more to go. You can help your Pokemon by using items at the right time. They can do more than just healing your Pokemon's HP. You can even boost their stats and things like that. It's pretty cool. And the school is an incinerator. Burning garbage can be the only way to reduce the volume of waste. That also will be a good heater. Well, that'll make the school warm. Just use that as a way to heat the school. You got a system going there, guys. Keep it up. Wait, there's a Pokeball right here. Oh, you get a potion. Yay! That's only if they can connect the incinerator to the whole school system. That'd be pretty cool. You wanna know why I'm standing here? Because I'm the strongest, that's why. I won't even bother battling you unless you can beat everyone else here. Oh, wow! Big words! Big words for some... I was about to say for someone... For a baby like you, but he's actually taller than me. I was gonna say for like a small person like you. Oh, no. Oh, no! Retreat! Retreat! The plan of Sass talking him failed! Ready and... Grass, Fire, Water! Which one wins again? Which one win in a matchup between Grass type and Water type? Oh wait, Grass and Water type? Fire would win, totally! Of course! I mean, Grass and Water, okay, Grass would win. The Fire option threw me off a little bit. Yeah, right, that's it! You must be a great trainer! Oh, thanks for acknowledging my abilities as a trainer. Oh, we can go indoors right there. But first of all, let's go over to the side area. I want to explore outside before we go inside. There's grass here. I wonder what Pokemon are here this time. I know Alolan Muk was here in the original. Or I mean, Alolan Grimer? Alolan Meowth is here, actually. I've never seen this Pokemon set. I like how they do this for battles. When there's a new Pokemon, Rotom will say something about them, so he's like a little companion in like scanning the Pokemon as well. When you meet them for the first time, it's kind of like, oh, what's this creature? If you've never met it before. Which I think is really cute that he lets you know when something's new as well. Alright, so I'm not gonna use Alola Miyatame team. There's only 6 slots. I gotta choose carefully, but Alola Miyatame is pretty cool. Oh wait, there's a Pokeball! I got an antidote! Yay! I'm after buying some though, but that's fine. They could be useful at any time in the game. Oh, and a Paralyzed Heal too! There's lots of stuff out here. I kinda wanna keep going in the gas, because I wanna see what else is here, see if there's anything new. I'll show you my Grimer's best move with Poison Gas. It'll poison everyone that can come at us. Even my poor little Usagi? No, you're not gonna hurt Usagi, alright? You got that, Youngster Joey! Oh my gosh, he's here! Guys, Youngster Joey's in this game. I mentioned him before, but he doesn't have a Rattata, which makes him not the same. I wish he had a Rattata so he'd be like the Youngster Joey I know. Oh, why aren't you like the Youngster Joey I know? Aww! I'm having flashbacks! These guys are level 7 though, they're actually pretty high leveled. They're jumping the levels quite a bit, so I'm kind of glad that my two Pokemon are level 11 and 12 to help take these guys down. And I'm really happy to be using Usagi more, but Usagi needs to learn more moves. Usagi only knows Pound, and I'm looking forward to getting another move. No, the Grimer found the tall grass near the school is defeated. Oh yeah, I'm guessing we still get it here then. But maybe there's a new Pokemon here as well, I'm curious. Grass type Pokemon are immune to powder moves like Poison Powder and Sleep Powder, but you can still poison them with Poison Gas. Good thing I wasn't using a Grass type then. Is there a new Pokemon in here that I can find, maybe? It's another Alola Meowth. Oh yeah, it's nighttime in the game. I think this is the first time we're playing the game at night for an episode, and I'm really excited about that. Wait! Oh, Usagi really wants to turn up play. Don't worry, we'll play soon. Don't worry, Usagi. We'll play some games. This guy's level 8 though, he's pretty high leveled, or she's pretty high leveled. I might come back and catch these guys for my Pokedex later, though I really want to catch them as I go along. But I know if I try to catch every Pokemon in an episode, I'll spend the next 20 years trying to catch them all. On screen as well, 20 years of recordings, guys. But like straight recordings, like 20 years, 265 days, 24 hours each day. That long. I hope Usagi learns a new move soon. I really want her to. Or him to. I really want him to. Oh, I kind of... Okay, I left. I wanted to get one more battle, but I accidentally left. So I guess we'll leave it at that. Okay, so I fought two... Did I fight two or three trainers? Will you fight me at... Oh, you won't battle me still? Is there someone else? Maybe I'm supposed to go indoors? Yeah, I fought two outdoors, so the rest must be inside the building. Let's go get them. I'll take the front door. There's also the side door, but we'll take this one first. Oh, I can't go into this room. Can I sneak inside the locker? I have a feeling I have to fight that kid right there. What about you? Look at your Pokemon. Whether it's solid or not now, it would probably get a kick out of this one. Is it a quick claw? Yes, we got a quick claw. Thank you! In Pokemon battles, the Pokemon with the highest speed stat gets attacked first, but with a quick claw, your Pokemon should be able to attack first regardless of speed. Or sometimes anyway, it's better than nothing. Some items don't do anything unless you give them to a Pokemon to hold. I'll give it to one of my team members in a bit, actually. I'm gonna explore a little bit first of this building. Oh, it's a classroom! Look at my Metapod! It's got an orange berry! Oh wait, you're actually gonna battle me? Oh my gosh, I wasn't expecting you to! Oh, she's so cute! I love her design! And the little poofy pigtails are adorable as well. You know, that's actually one thing I really love about the character design in this game, is her hairstyle is what I actually like to wear very often myself. Because the two plaits are super cute. So I often wear my hair like that, so I find it really funny that the main character of this game also has her hair like that. Which is pretty cool, because I feel like I relate to her more now. just because of hairstyle. We're gonna have to take down this Metapod, but it could take a while. This could take a long time. Oh no. Oh wait, I did a lot of damage actually. Oh, that was quite a bit. Okay, we should be able to do this. I think two more hits maybe. Okay, one more. One final hit and she'll be dead. Take this! Izaki, finish it! Metapod fainted. Oh yeah, I love stall battles. And victory! Oh, the experience share is on automatically. Metapod, here I have a berry! Can I have one too? For my own Pokemon? Oh yes, thank you! Yay! 3 orange berries! Metapod looks so cute munching down on an orange berry in the middle of battle. Teach, what have you been teaching these children? You occasionally ask Professor Cookie to run a special class for his school. He's done a great deal of research into Pokemon moves after all. Also, you got type advantages on the board. Do you want to battle too? I can read here, watch. Moves have taste just like Pokemon. If you use a move that's the same type as your Pokemon, oh yeah, it gets a boost in power, of course. Petty Ray Pokemon makes me happy too. Me too. Okay, power points. Yeah, cool. Thanks for the information. Who do you think picks up all the Pokeballs? You don't catch any Pokemon. Asking the real questions right here. This kid right here, he's too smart to me in this class. Move him up, agreed. Alright, guys? Bring him up, agreed. He knows too much. He knows too many secrets, so... Where does this lead to? Does this just lead me outside? Oh, it's just the side door. Alright, I guess next stop is up the stairs. But before we go up there and fight this kid, I'm gonna equip the Quick Claw. Let's give the Quick Claw to... Who's Solar, actually? I have a feeling Popplio's Solar. I haven't checked their stats on screen yet, actually. Oh, wait, their stats are displayed in a really cute way. Oh, I like that. I like them a lot. Yeah, Popo is way slower, I had a feeling. I just wanted to check to make sure. So, Popo, I'm gonna give you an item today, so you better take care of it. Here's your Quick Claw, Popo. And also, I might give... Will I give Usagi an item, too? What do I have for Usagi? What would you like? I could give you an orange berry. I don't think it's that helpful, though. I prefer to give orange berries to baby Pokemon. Because I feel like baby Pokemon use them most often. Oh, you stinking meow. Why do you always love to park it right at the base of the stairs? Meha! Oh, wait, I have to go fight the guy outside, of course. I almost forgot about him. See, he's so bad at battling, I almost forgot. Actually, I think Lily can heal us. Oh, thank you! Alright, Bunnyray did need a little bit of healing, so I'm glad that she healed us right there. So you can do that when you're in this area. Now, let's go! Looks like you beat everybody else, huh? But don't think you'll beat me the same way. Ekans' ability is gonna get you! Are you sure about that? My Usagi right here has a couple things to say about that, Joseph. My Bunnyray has got a couple things to say. Alright, so here's Ekans right here. What was this Ekans' ability? I don't know if it's different than the original, but I don't remember what it was, so I guess we'll find out. Intimidate! Wow, Joseph, you really got the upper hand here. That's why I'm gonna keep pounding away in this battle. Yeah, I still do decent damage. That's actually not bad. We're stuck in a rap, though! Oh, no! It looks like we're caught in... What are those called? Are they called, like... I think they're called slinkies? You know the things that you have like that where you can, like... You can... I don't know. They're like that and they just bounce around and you just... You hold them in your hand and you just bounce them. Is that what they're called? I have no idea. Do you know what I'm talking about? Do I know what I'm talking about? They remind me of slinkies. I think that's what they're called. But they're just these things where you basically mush them together. And then, you know, you hold it like that and then you just start splashing it about and then it goes like that. I don't know, does that make sense? I don't know. It probably doesn't make sense. I'm gonna check up the name after this. I have no idea if they're called that now and I need to know. It's like you got an experience boost right there and so did the rest of the party. Winning you after your attack set is lowered, an indomitable you say earlier, Joseph, that you'd be the last one I fight? You know, I prefer fighting that kid indoors than fighting you. That Metapod was tougher. It can lower your opponent's attack power. If you can understand your Pokemon's abilities, you can use the best strategies in battle. But fine, whatever. I can admit it when I'm beat. I'll give you a reward even. Take this technical machine. Oh, we got worked up! That's our first TM of the game! TM 1, yay! Okay, first thing to know about TMs, technical machines teach new techniques. They'll give your Pokemon new move and a flash. But if your Pokemon can't learn the move in a TM, then too bad. You're up the creek, pal. Second thing to know about TMs, you can use them as many times as you want, which I'm so glad you can do now. As many different Pokemon as you want. They don't wear out or get used up. Pretty nice gift for me, huh? Oh, that's the school bell! Attention all students, would Safi please come to the office on the second floor? Safi to 2F office, please. What terrible thing did you do to get called to the office so soon? Nothing. Wow. So you did do something! She looks so disappointed. Are you in trouble? I head up to the second floor as soon as you can. Can you heal me just in case? Alright, I think we have to find another teacher or something. So I'm just scared, so I want to heal first just in case. Alright, let's go indoors. Alright, time to take on the second floor. I am ready, I think. Safi, I can't believe that you beat all my students. Fantastic, after seeing such a powerful performance, I think I'd like to battle you myself. What do you say? Are you ready? Yes. Bring it, teacher! Good, I heard about you from Professor Cookie. I'll be challenging you with a Pokemon that is a type of match against popular you chose for your partner. That's so evil, she's like, hehe. I purposely did this. You were challenged by teacher Emily. She's kinda like your rival who usually picks what's super effective on you. Okay, she's got a Rowlet, but don't you worry. I got Usagi right here, and Usagi's been taking down this place very easily. This could be a tougher battle, though. A level 10 Rowlet, that's pretty high leveled, actually. Ooh, but Usagi does quite a bit of damage, but it's a good thing we even have Usagi here, because otherwise, you know, my best friend Popo might die. But I think Usagi should be able to hold up the battle. I'm taking quite a bit of damage, though. I am faster, though, so I think I will kill Rowlet quicker than Rowlet will kill me, unless she has a potion. Yep, she's going for leafage again. Oh, I'm so weak, but I'm pretty sure I hit first. Alright, finish it, Usagi. Finish it. Yes, there goes Rowlet. Oh, I feel kind of bad. I get some experience with... Oh, Popo, get a level 13. Awesome. Sensational. And you call yourself a teacher. Nice. Maybe you'd like to take over as teacher here for me. All joking aside, though, I do want you to take these from me. It's a little reward for beating me. Oh, five great balls! Yes! They're great balls. Great balls are better at catching Pokemon than normal Pokeballs. Know your Pokemon and know their moves. Those are the basics of being a trainer. How about it? Oh my gosh, this is one of my favorite characters in this game! It's Lima! He's probably one of my favorites. Oh, he's adorable! Greetings, Captain Lima here. I couldn't help but observe your battle. You look still very delightful in battle, but I had no choice but to summon you here. This is Safi, who moved here to Alola from the Kanto region. She's got a real sense of... for how to use moves, and I think she's gonna go far as a trainer, yeah? I see, then welcome, newcomer. I look forward to seeing the brilliance of your moves in my trial. Indeed, we captains are the ones who conduct the trials you'll face on your way to challenging the Isla Kahuna. My trial is held in Verdant Cavern, the trial of Captain Lima. I can't wait to see how they change this trial. I know they've changed a lot of them. You can find Pokemon living everywhere, even in the patches of tall grass in Hoholy City. Perhaps you'll want to fill out your team a little bit before attempting my trial. I sincerely look forward to your challenge. Oh, my Lima! I love his hair color. Oh, yeah. I reported to the folks upstairs about that Tauros blocking the road out front again. That guy's Tauros is pretty much a celebrity here in Melly Melly, you know? Well, I guess it's time that we dismissed you from school, Safi. Finally! I can leave! No more school ever again! Attention all students, Safi has completed her last like this, you know, it's just a one-day process and then you're done. Be good to your Pokemon and try to follow through with those status conditions too. Good luck with your island challenge! Have fun and give your Pokemon any berries you find! Safi, enjoy your island challenge and be sure to use the skills you learned here at the trainer school! Good luck, future champion! Make sure you use that tea and make your Pokemon the strongest! So what you made us happy. I love all the encouragement coming from everyone. You seem to be in perfect sync with your Bunny, aren't you? Since we've come this far together, why don't I show you some more of the city? Come on, there's lots to see. I love how Lily's like our tour guide, and she shows us around the place that's super cute. So, I guess we're at a trainer school now. Oh, there's Lily waiting for us. Happy over here, she's so cute. Time to head off on your journey together! You know, I was really impressed seeing how you battled with your Pokemon at the trainer school. It feels like you're really giving it your all for your Pokemon's sake. I think that's why you were able to save Nebby that time, Safi. Oh, I forgot about Tauros! Oh no, yes, and Moot! More! I love how Hal's having like a little dance party all on his own. Oh, but isn't Lily and Safi? Sorry for scaring you, friend. I guess it's time I get old Tauros back home. Oh, but I've got an idea. Why not give him a little pet, Safi? Are you gonna pet that big old Tauros? I bet my... Wait, my chassis is 100 times smoother. Alright, I'll pet it. Where will you try petting Tauros? Pet its face, stroke its mane, grab it by the tail. Stroke its mane. I feel like that's the normal thing to do. That does... Oh, no. Okay, I guess maybe the face? Whoa! Huh, you see that this rascal already loves you. Pokemon become happier when we show them some care. Oh, are they trying to tell me to look after my Pokemon now? Wahaha! Oh, the places you'll go, child. And as you do, you'll surely meet more Pokemon and people who will enrich your life. The Kahuna is sure something, eh? Able to calm a raging Pokemon without even needing to battle. Now that's something. I mean, I like Tauros play and all, but it's pretty scary. Don't want to ride on it. So where are you two off to now? I was thinking I could show Safi around Hoholy City a bit. Nice idea. You're always on top of things, Lily. Safi just got here to Alola, huh? But let me tag along too. I want to go get something good to eat. Is he going to be obsessed with Malasala again? Alright, let's all go together. I hope he's still obsessed with it. It was part of the experience, the sun and moon. Then what are we waiting for? This way, come on! Oh yay! We're all going shopping in the city together! Oh, how? I guess we should go catch up with him before he gets too far, Safi. Hoholy City is the biggest city in all Alola. Alright, well guys, I'm afraid even though Rotom can smell the city, we will be going there next time, so thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you all have a wonderful day.